Cleo's really special because she was actually born right here at Australia Zoo. Definitely one of my favourite snakes. They're actually the largest snake, the longest snake in the entire world.
They start off at about a metre and then they grow quite rapidly. Right up until when they're, you know, 25 feet long.
That size, they could actually eat someone my size.
She might be a little bit grumpy because when they shed their skin, they get a little bit kind of, they can't see as well.
She's a little bit opaque, which means she's about to shed. Of course, it's coming into winter, so they stop feeding during that period. So it's good to get some food into her prior to that, and that's what we're doing today.
So she'll either just sit there or she'll try and kill you.
I'm really excited to go in and feed her with Wes.
Your dad got nailed by one day and it was hilarious.
Have a go at this. What a beauty. You're a bit grumpy, sweetheart. You're all right, you're all right. She's all right. You're all right now. You're all right, sweetheart. Whoa, 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 whoa. Settle down. Settle down. You're right. Look at her opening up her mouth. Really upset, very agitated. Oh, crikey.
You can close the door, mate. Rob him. He'll be fine. Look, if the snake grabs him, we'll get it off him. Don't worry.
There's never a dull moment when you're working with Wes.
Come on, darling. When she smells this,
yeah,
it'll be on.
Whoa. How cool is that?
That's wild. Wow, just that instant coil. That was incredible.
Imagine if she grabbed you, you know, she's got enough strength that she'll just, you'll literally be like that in a second.
Wow.
And you know, those teeth, they're like this long, they're curved, and when they hit, the harder you pull, the tighter they go
in. Just can't get them out.
Constriction is just like instant. Tightens a little bit and a little bit, and then it's like, good night.
But she'll gently let go and then she'll start hunting around for the head.
Mm-hmm. It's awesome.
I love retics. The bottom part of the right-hand jaw goes underneath and goes, cuts, gets the teeth in on that side and then pulls and it's like this.
She almost looks like she's completely unhinging her whole head.
Reticulated means unbroken pattern, which means it never ends. That's where the name comes from.
She'll digest that food source in about 2 weeks. Snakes shed their skins depending on how fast they're growing. She'll go into a shed cycle, and then they'll just be this incredibly vibrant, beautiful snake after that.
This morning on my morning rounds, I noticed Cleo was in the process of shedding her skin. But she seemed to be having some difficulty doing that. Snakes shed their skin as they grow. So when they're small, they will shed more often. As they get to Cleo's size, she probably sheds at the moment around once every 6 weeks or so. So when a snake sheds its skin, if there's a little bit of an issue there, or perhaps the environment is a little more dry than usual, they may seek out water to help peel that old skin off. We will give her a nice warm bath. We'll let her soak in that, and hopefully the skin will then very easily be able to be removed. Do you want to just check the temperature of that water before we pop her in?
Yep, perfect, 28.
We're going to just guide her in with as least disturbance to her as possible. Just pop her through and
she should hopefully just slide straight in.
Yeah, goodo, without too much. All right. Reticulated pythons are native to Southeast Asia. They're relatively common, but they are at threat these days, particularly due to capturing either for the pet trade, but especially for the skin trade.
When a snake sheds, it's a pretty amazing process. But if there's an issue and a piece gets stuck on, the next time the snake sheds, it'll hit that little bumpy section and another piece will get stuck. And then that will build up over time. Bacteria can get in there and then you have issues.
Good girl. She's such a darling. The reason she's had trouble shedding, in winter, the air gets a lot drier. this can affect when they're going through shedding processes, if the humidity is not quite high enough during that period. If it doesn't come off, it can lead to progressive problems. It can be bacteria that will take hold or fungal elements as well. So we need to make sure she gets all of this skin off this time round.
If you want to pop that over there.
You're all right, sweetheart. Yeah, I know.
I know she's usually a sweetheart, but just be mindful, hey?
Good girl. You're all right.
The skin shed is starting to lift, but it needs really a little bit more time. And rather than really get her grumpy now, we'll let her sit for a little bit longer, for probably another half an hour, and come back and reassess at that point.
So if that doesn't work, soaking in this tub, we'll need to use something a little bit more abrasive. Worst case scenario, we might need to even use a scrubbing brush or something a bit harsher to get the skin off.
Nice and gentle. It's all right. She's good.
She is so incredibly strong. It's taking, five of us potentially to hold her down.
Yeah, I just don't think there was any way we were getting this off without grabbing her. It's coming off. It's coming off.
We have to be very careful when we're peeling this skin off because the scales underneath are a little bit more sensitive than usual, and we just need to make sure that we don't cause too much trauma.
Yeah, I know, sweetie. Yeah. Cleo has been the perfect patient so far.
The skin actually looks really healthy underneath.
Yeah.
Really healthy.
Now, Cleo is a placid snake, but she still has the ability to bite, and she has a mouthful of teeth that can really do some damage.
Surely this must feel good when it's off.
The time frame that this may take is a bit like how long is a piece of string. Hopefully not too long. But it really depends on if we strike any stubborn areas of skin.
Yeah, it's really hard there. Okay. This section here is the worst.
Now, now. Play nice. One kiss.
The scrubbing brushes we're using are extremely soft, but it gives us a little more abrasion to help get that skin off, but it doesn't hurt her.
Jess is just going to touch the eye.
About to check to see if she's got a retained spectacle. Sorry, honey. Oh, all good.
We're close, sweetheart.
We're close, guys.
Okay, just got this very small but stubborn area left. It all has to come off, one way or another. This is not a process that we want to go through again and again. If we don't do a thorough job this time, the likelihood is it will happen again. Her skin's actually looking pretty good and has improved already. One, two, three.
Good girl.
Just to be on the extra safe side, we're going to keep her at an elevated temperature overnight, and we can have a good look at her in the morning as well.
So I'm just doing a close examination of the dorsal surface of her body where the majority of those scales were retained.
Sorry, yeah. No worries. So we'll stick it straight over that one.
She looks great at first glance. That inflammation's definitely subsided. So that's fantastic. I'm really happy with how it's looking. And those sensitive scales where we removed all that retained slough from, they're looking really healthy. So I'm really pleased with how she's looking and more than happy for her to go back on display.
Okay. Oh.
Gee, she just looks absolutely fantastic. And
yep.
She's nice and strong and still quite chilled. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Really pleased.
Yeah,
she's